great to see you here. In this new video, I will talk about three distributions that are used a lot in project management. The first one is the normal distribution. The second distribution is the beta distribution. And the third distribution is the triangular distribution. Before starting, don't forget to click on the subscribe button, click on the bell button, and every time we have a new video, YouTube will inform you about it. Let's start with the normal distribution. The normal distribution is also called the bell curve or the Gauss distribution. And it can be described with two parameters, mu and sigma. Mu is the average and sigma is the standard deviation. I will go deeper into this, but first of all, what you see here is a symmetrical distribution. It means that the surface to the left and to the right of the average is exactly 50%. Now, when we see here, we have the average, the black line, and then we have three intervals, and each interval is one sigma further to the left or to the right. It wouldn't mean a lot. It would be exactly the same surface that we would find. When we see between the average and one standard deviation, we find 34.1%. Between one sigma and two sigma, we find 13.6%. And between 2 and 3 sigma, we find 2.1%. It means that when we have the average plus 1 sigma, at the left-hand side, we have 84.1%. On the other hand, when we look at the right-hand side, we have 34%. So basically, we have 15.9% to the right of the average and one standard deviation. This distribution is used in many applications. We find a lot of events, elements that are, let's say, showing a bell distribution, a normal distribution. For example, the distribution of the intelligence coefficient. There are other things. Now, one of the things is also very important when we look at operations management and we look at sampling. Whenever we start sampling from a distribution, whatever the original distribution of the population is, the sampling distribution of the sample averages is in fact a normal distribution. And that's why the normal distribution is so interesting when we are calculating certain parameters. When we have, for example, the PERT or the three-point formula that we use, we find an average and a standard deviation. And with that, we can use the normal distribution to draw or to calculate the link between the duration, for example, and the probability. Another very interesting element about a normal distribution is what we call the empiric rule. And when we look at the graph, we can say that mu plus or minus sigma, so the number of points between mu minus sigma up to mu plus one sigma, that contains approximately 68.2% of the data. When we look at it two sigma, there we find 95.4% of the data, and mu plus or minus 3 sigma, we find approximately 99.6% of the data. This is also called the empiric rule, and we can apply it on a population or on a sample. So very interesting to understand this, to remember these things. You can use this distribution to calculate the probability that a project will be finished in less than a certain time, in more than a certain time, between two times. These are all possibilities that you can do using the normal distribution. We also have the beta probability distribution, and this is the distribution which is in fact giving the probability of occurrence between a minimum and a maximum value. Where the normal distribution was going from minus infinity to plus infinity, the beta distribution is limited between two values, a minimum and a maximum. Now, we have different forms, and the beta probability distribution contains two form factors, alpha and beta. And depending on the values of alpha and beta, the beta distribution will have a different form. There are different possibilities, like triangular distribution, normal but limited between a minimum and a maximum value, skewed to the left or the right, or even a uniform distribution. The beta distribution has been the basis for the calculation of the PERT assessments. the beta probability was the basis to find the PERT function, the PERT formula that we use, a plus 4 m plus b divided by 6, and the standard deviation b minus a divided by 6. Now, there is also the equation and the graph. Be aware, this is quite some equation. You don't have to know this equation by heart, of course. The only thing is that you can find the beta probability distribution. You can find it in Excel, and it's quite easy to use. So when you go to beta dist, you find, in fact, the way how to enter the different data, the minimum, the maximum, x, the value x, and the form factors alpha and beta. Let's have a look at different forms. When alpha is equal to beta is equal to 1, we have a uniform distribution. It means that basically these are random variables, all have the same probability. Alpha equal 1 and beta is equal to, we have a triangular distribution with the mode at the minimum. We have alpha is beta is 2, which is a normal distribution-like distribution. We find this is also between a minimum and a maximum, but it's very close to the normal distribution. Alpha is 2, beta is 1. In this case, we have a triangular distribution where the maximum is at the max value of the distribution. Then we have alpha is 2 and beta is 4. We have skewed to the right where we have this distribution. And then we have alpha equal to 4, beta equal to 2, and we have a skew to the left distribution. So basically, you can use this formula quite easily. You can adjust it to different parameters. When we look it into graphs, we have the beta cumulative probability distributions for the different elements that we had. So I calculated for the different values. You can find this. You can do this easily in Excel. We see it for alpha is beta equal to 1 is like the dark orange, the yellow alpha is 1, beta is 2, and so on. So you see how this distribution, the cumulative distribution, looks like. We also have the different values here for the beta mass probability distributions. We have the same data as before, but now you can alpha is beta equal to 1. You see it's a very nice uniform distribution. We have the normal looking distribution. It's not exactly like the normal distribution, but it's a little bit in the same style. So basically, you see, these are the different possibilities that we have with the beta distribution, with the beta function. The last one that I want to talk about is the triangular probability distribution. It's become more and more popular, and it describes events of which we do not really know the real probability distribution. And also we have an outcome that can vary between a minimum and a maximum value. It's a little bit of an simplification. We have a triangle, the top is the mode, and the top typically is between the minimum and the maximum. The mode or the top is the value with the highest probability. The distribution has become very popular in risk and project management, based on the three-point estimation. The three-point estimation is basically founded on the triangular probability distribution. The equation and the graphs, when we look at the different calculations, when we look at the triangular distribution, we have a minimum and a maximum value and the mode, the value m. We have the two surfaces and the height of the triangle is h. We can say that for values between a, for x between a and the mode, we have the relationship 2 divided by b minus a times x minus a divided by m minus a. It's basically the equation of a line. And then we have another line between for x between m and b, which is 2 divided by b minus a multiplied by b minus x divided by m minus a. So basically, these are the different elements that we have, and it's zero elsewhere. So outside for values of x smaller than a or larger than b, the value of the triangular distribution is zero. So these are the most important distributions that you will encounter in project management when we will be looking into other applications, for example, the Monte Carlo method, Monte Carlo simulation. In that case, we can give other distributions to the different activities, but that is out of scope of this presentation and this part of the course. Anyway, that was all that I wanted to tell you. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button, click on the bell button, and every time we have a new video, YouTube will inform you about it. Thank you very much, and bye-bye.